What's going on, guys? Sean Nalawani here, seannal.com, bodytransformationtruth.com, and in this video, I want to give a simplified explanation on the issue of sodium intake as it relates to water retention and bloating, as well as to overall health. A lot of people ask about this mainly because they want to minimize subcutaneous water retention, so the amount of water that's stored directly beneath the skin, because doing that will increase visible muscle definition and give you sort of a leaner, drier look as opposed to looking softer and more bloated. And then on top of that, if you're involved in bodybuilding and fitness, then you're probably reasonably health conscious as well. And we've all heard all kinds of things about how sodium increases blood pressure and leads to hypertension. And so a lot of people are confused on that as well. So the first thing to understand is that sodium itself is not inherently bad. It's actually critical for your health for a variety of reasons. And the goal is not to minimize sodium intake or to somehow eliminate it. I don't recommend going to extremes, but the problem isn't necessarily the objective amount of sodium in your diet. But instead, what you need to look out for is, number one, the ratio of sodium to potassium that you're consuming, and number two, the consistency of your sodium intake from day to day. These are the things that can cause excessive water retention and potential negative health effects. So, first off, as a general guideline, you want to be consuming about as much potassium as sodium in your diet. So about a 1-to-1 ratio. And the average person in the West takes in significantly more sodium than potassium each day. And potassium intake is actually one of the most common nutrient deficiencies in the Western diet. Now, it's not going to be practical for most people to go through and track exactly how much sodium and how much potassium they're consuming. So instead, I would recommend just taking some basic steps to keep your sodium intake reasonably under control, while at the same time making an effort to get in foods that are high in potassium in order to make sure that that ratio is decently balanced. So in terms of controlling sodium, you're looking at basic things like moderating your intake of canned and prepackaged types of foods, not going overboard on high sodium fast food types of meals, not excessively salting your food or using too many high sodium sauces or dressing, things like that. And then in terms of increasing potassium intake, I'll put a list of foods on the screen here just to show you some examples of potassium-rich foods, and you can just pause the video to check that out. Now again, because it's probably more so the ratio between sodium and potassium that is important, if you're already taking in or you're already getting a lot of potassium-rich foods in your diet, then the fact that maybe you do consume a decent amount of sodium as well, that might not be an issue. But I'm just speaking in general here because the average person does consume a lot more sodium than potassium, so it is something to take a look at in order to see what sort of ratio you might be dealing with. And then the second thing to consider here, if you're trying to keep water retention and bloating under control, is the consistency of your sodium intake from day to day. I'm sure most people have had that experience where your sodium intake is reasonably consistent, and then you go out and eat a particularly big meal or two that are really high in sodium, and then the next day you notice that you have sort of that soft and bloated look. Or the opposite can happen too. Even though most people think that minimizing their sodium intake is going to reduce water retention, going from moderate or high sodium intake straight to a low sodium intake, that can have the same effect as well and can actually increase water retention and bloating. And without going into detail, this is basically caused by changes in your body's levels of aldosterone, which is a hormone that regulates water balance. Now, short-term fluctuations in sodium intake are obviously normal, and it's really not a big deal because once you go back to your normal diet, it will balance itself out. But if you do want to keep water retention controlled from day to day, or if you want to avoid looking bloated for a certain occasion, that's just something to be aware of, and try to keep your sodium intake reasonably consistent in the big picture. Don't suddenly increase it and don't suddenly decrease it. So bottom line on all of this, Sodium itself is not evil. You don't need to minimize sodium intake. And it's really just about basic balance and moderation in the big picture. And you can achieve that by keeping your sodium to potassium ratio balanced, either by reducing your sodium intake if it's particularly high, or by increasing your intake of potassium, or through a combination of both. And then the second thing is by keeping your sodium intake reasonably balanced from day to day, rather than allowing for big up and down fluctuations. That's really all there is to it. So I hope this was helpful. Make sure to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram if you aren't already. You can grab my complete body transformation blueprint that provides all of the training and nutrition information you need to reach your fitness goals as effectively as possible by clicking here or by using the link in the description box. The official website is seannell.com, and if you did enjoy the video, feel free to share, like, comment, and subscribe to stay up to date. Talk to you guys again soon.